Welcome to Friday Night Smackdown, ladies and gentlemen. As we kick things off with a Women's Elimination Chamber qualifying match. Coming to the ring first, representing the LWO, Zelina Vega. By Damage Control member Dakota Kai and EO Sky. EO Sky, who is the WWE Women's Champion. And see, the thing is, we still don't know who Charlotte is challenging. She could be challenging EO. She could be challenging Rhea. But as of right now, we do not know what title these women are going after for the Elimination Chamber. So just imagine Bayley advancing here tonight, and she wins the Elimination Chamber, and Charlotte picks Rhea. Then that means we'll see Bayley going one-on-one with EO Sky. But that's if she could get the win here tonight, as Zelina Vega is looking to stamp her name here in the WWE. In what way than to get a huge win over a former women's champion in Bayley. Bayley with a nice shoulder tackle to start things off. Working on that left leg, pummeling the knee of Zelina. She's pummeling that knee. She throws Zelina into the corner. Oh, slams her head into that turnbuckle. Forearm into the corner as Zelina falls down into the corner. Stomping away into Zelina. Just wiping her face on the mat with an elbow to the back by Bayley. Bayley with a right kick to the head. And she goes for another one. As Zelina Vega rolls to the outside, Bayley's to the top rope. Oh, Damage Control, look at him getting involved already. Wait a minute. Referee just kicked out Dakota Kai. But you look, as EO Sky just threw Zelina Vega into the ring, Bayley to the top. And she waits for Vega to get to her feet. Diving crossbody by Bayley. Goes for the pin. One, two, and a kick out by Zelina Vega. Wait, EO Sky just brought a kendo stick into the ring. Distracting the ref is now putting the weapon out of the ring. Bayley slamming Vega's head into the mat. Forearm by Bayley. And then a strike to the back. Disrespectful, slapping the hell out of Zelina Vega as Bayley goes to the top rope. Going for here. Unless she's going to go for an elbow drop. Zelina went for some shit and failed. Ah. Nice exploder suplex right there by Bayley. Bayley has been working on his left leg of Zelina's.
Look at this turnbuckle shit. Here we go again. Managers. I mean, I like adding managers because it adds to the story. It adds to the realism. But like, dude, these turnbuckles, bro.
Like, why are you even distracting the ref when Bayley has been having all the whole offense, bro? Bayley throws Zelina Vega to the outside. Oh, what a baseball slide. A baseball slide from one side to another. Knee smash by Bayley. And another one. Oh, she went for another one, but Zelina moved out of the way. Oh, but wait. Bayley fighting out of it. Bayley fought out of it. Oh my gosh, a vicious clothesline. Referee at 7. These women need to get back into the ring. As Bayley tosses Zelina back, Bayley goes to the top rope. Zelina gets to her feet. Diving crossbody by Bayley. And you see here, the distraction, though. The distraction. Like, come on, what if Bayley went for that pin? Oh, and a running knee into the corner. Now she's choking Zelina. She's choking Zelina now. As Bayley goes to the top rope yet again.
Come on, ref, get out the way.
Elbow drop by Bayley. 1, 2, 3, and Bayley moves on to the Elimination Chamber.
Damage control. You.
What a nice competitive match that was to start the night off. Here comes the United States champion, Logan Paul, the man who came off of a defeat by the hands of Rey Mysterio at the Royal Rumble.
I'm not even going to get into it. I heard me talk shit. Episode 1. Oh yes, Logan Paul lost his match. He's still the United States champion. Whatever, let's move on. Fuck it.
Logan Paul did ambush Rey Mysterio after his match last week against Scripps. He clocked Rey Mysterio over the head with the United States title. And now tonight, Logan Paul goes one-on-one with LWO member Hakeem Wild. Wild looking to avenge fellow LWO member Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio, you might have won the match, but I'm still the US champion.
Yes, you are, bro. Don't remind me about the bullshit.
As we all know, you're past your prime. There is no way you would have beat me by pinfall or submission.
Okay, advertising man.
Tonight, I am going to show you how a real champion wins matches. As I defeat one of your own members of the LWO. So bring out that chump.
Oh, okay. Logan talking greasy.
Joaquin Wilde. Better come out here. Could have beaten him, Logan. He better rep for that LWO.
Hopefully this man's going in a condo though. Dude, ain't no way in hell you will tell me Rey Mysterio won both of his matches by condo.
I mean, if that's Rey's way of winning, I mean, that's cool, but you can't win no championships like that, my guy. What are we doing? Wild moves out of the way. Logan moves out of the way. Okay. That's what we doing, ladies and gentlemen. These right hooks by Logan was trying to take Wild down, but a drop kick did it. As Wild is on the outside. Paul, top rope. Oh my gosh, a neck breaker from the top rope. Onto the outside and a kick to the back to Joaquin. Joaquin. Why do you think just call my man's DJ Z, though? Like, whatever, bro. I got many times they're gonna keep missing moves, bro. And a kick to the gut by Joaquin Wild. And an elbow to the chest of Logan Paul. Nice splash by Wild. Kick to the back of Logan Paul. Is he gonna go for another splash again? Yes, he is. As Wild throws Paul to the outside. And Paul looks hurt. He looks battered and bruised.
Come on, what's the point? I hate this animation. What's the point of that animation, bro? Like, 2K, bro.
Wild on the top rope. Crossbody. Like a frog splash crossbody to the outside. Elbow to the chest. Strike to the back of Logan Paul. Logan Paul with a counter as he throws Wild into the ring. I mean, I don't...
Why didn't Wild take advantage of that, bro?
Oh my gosh, choking him on the rope. Paul goes for the pin. One. Kick out at one. Back body drop by Logan Paul goes for a springboard crossbody dive. And a left hook to Wild. Big boot by Logan Paul. And Logan Paul goes for a suplex. Suplex by Logan Paul.
What Logan got cooking?
What Logan got cooking as he missed.
A little back and forth.
Logan with some nice strikes, a little combo ending with a clothesline. Referee at a count of six.
Logan Paul in the ring now. Is he gonna win this match by count out?
Referee at a count of eight. Can Wild get back into the ring? Referee at a count of nine. Okay, Logan. He definitely would have won that match by count out. I mean, he did tell Rey he's going to show him how a world champion wins. He wasn't going to win this match by count out. Hurricane Rana by Wild. Wild goes into the ring now. Clothesline by Wild. Head scissors. Head scissors takedown. And now we move on to a men's qualifying match for the Elimination Chamber. Making his way to the ring, carrying Cross. Cross has yet to get that big win here in the WWE. That win to establish himself here on Friday Night SmackDown. Maybe he could get that win here tonight, go into Elimination Chamber, do big things in that match. But only if he can get past his opponent here tonight. And Karrion Kross's opponent, the Legend Killer, the Viper, Randy Orton. Now, the last time we seen Randy Orton was this Monday, on Monday Night Raw, when he viciously attacked John Cena. It looked like John Cena was gonna issue his farewell to the WWE, and then he got attacked by Randy Orton. Randy Orton hit him with an RKO out of nowhere. Clocked him upside the head with a steel chair and hit him with another RKO. Now, we haven't heard anything back about the health of John Cena. But it looked like Randy Orton wanted to be the one to send Cena packing. Will Randy Orton go on to the Elimination Chamber? Or is he still too focused on John Cena? Clothesline by Randy Orton. Another clothesline by Randy. Elbow to the back of Cross.
Bro, what the fuck? At least call the rope break when he actually pins him. Like, bro, 2K, fix your shit.
Swing up. Damn. Russian leg sweep. Voices. New voices. And Randy goes, oh, and he goes for another strike. And now he's pummeling away on Karrion Kross.
Now, I know it shows like that they be getting busted open, and I hate that, like, when blood is off, they still show you when they get busted open and then they're not bleeding. I feel like that shit is stupid. But I feel like I'm only saving blood for like pay-per-view matches, like matches that I know will be like big matches and shit. Cause like bleeding every week, cause like I feel like they bleed in every match, so it's like, you know.
Karrion Kross with a reversal. As he throws Randy into the ropes. Oh my gosh, the strength! The strength of Karrion Kross with a belly to belly.
Tripping right there, it looked like Cross is bleeding.
Maybe he a little bruised. Or maybe he got just some red shit in his eyes, because it looked like it's in his eyes, but I don't know. I'm a blind man, don't listen to me. Swinging neck breaker by Randy Orton. And a counter by Karrion Kross. Nice back and forth action between these two men. Spinning at back elbow.
I'm telling you, that left eye Cross looked fucked up.
As he's choking Randy now.
Uh-oh.
A headbutt to the back of the head of Randy Orton as Randy rolls to the outside. Cross coming around that corner, and a chop to the chest.
Uh-oh.
Snake eyes to the barricade.
Now let's see if Randy is busted open, then Brody is open. But I'm pretty sure I got Brody. It just looked like either Cross is like bleeding or his eyes bruised, because you know they got the new mechanics and shit. Referee at a count of five, Karrion Kross choking the life out of Randy Orton. Referee at a count of six, Kross gets into the ring. Randy makes his way to the ring. Oh my gosh, and a running knee strike. Kross goes for the pin. One. Kick out at one. Yeah, it doesn't appear that Randy's bleeding. My gosh, it's over. It has to be over here. It has to be over. One, two, and a kick out at two by Randy Orton. Oh, look at this strength. The strength of Karrion Kross. Power bomb to Randy Orton. A vicious power bomb. Oh, you know he was going to go for a strike here. A nice little right haymaker, but Randy reversed it. Got him over his shoulder. Snake eyes on the turnbuckle. Goes for the pin. One. Kick out at one. Maybe he's got some dark eyes or something. Like that eye, like he got baggy eyes or something. Maybe it ain't good, man. I'm just saying, damn. I'm an old blind man. Don't listen to me. Karrion Kross throwing Randy back into the ring. Oh, Randy. Oh, they having a slap to the chest. Right hook. Slap to the, nope. Right hook. Right hook. Left hook. Or right hook by Kross. Another right hook by Kross. Go for a slap to the chest. Right hook. How many times is this man gonna blow? Goddamn. Drop kick by Randy Orton. Nice little back and forth. Randy taunting now. The Viper taunting. He's going to the corner and a clothesline in the corner. Go for a pin. One, two, kick out at two. RKO! RKO! One, two, three, and Randy Orton advances to the Royal Rumble. What a match, what a main event. That was a great main event, ladies and gentlemen. Only episode 2 of SmackDown. And we off to a great start, road to WrestleMania. One more week until Elimination Chamber. What a great night, what a great main event. See you guys next week.